Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today we have to discuss about one of the most important C program for converting Celsius temperature to Fahrenheit temperature. It is one of the basic C program. Everybody must know this program. In the previous videos, we are already discussed about 6 basic programs. They are also important programs. First program, C program for printing first n natural numbers. Second program, C program for finding out sum of first n natural numbers. Third program, C program to print first n odd numbers and n even numbers. Next program, C program for finding out sum of n odd numbers and n even numbers. Next program, C program to check whether the given year is leap year or not. So these are the basic programs that are already discussed in the previous videos. If anybody wants, please refer that videos in my YouTube channel, Develop Srinivas Rao. Now, in this video, we have to discuss about how to convert the given Celsius temperature to equivalent Fahrenheit temperature. So, given temperature is Celsius temperature. Celsius temperature. So, Celsius temperature can be denoted by capital C. Fahrenheit, we have to convert this Celsius temperature to equivalent Fahrenheit temperature. Fahrenheit temperature can be denoted by capital F. Now, what is the formula we have to use to convert Celsius temperature into equivalent Fahrenheit temperature? So F is equal to C into 9 by 5 plus 32. So by using this formula, we have to find out the equivalent Fahrenheit temperature for the given Celsius temperature. Now, suppose I am taking Celsius temperature is 100. Okay, now we have to find out the equivalent Fahrenheit temperature. So, substitute C value, Celsius temperature value, 100 in the place of C, 9 by 5 plus 32. Here, 5 20 times, 20 into 9, so plus 32, so 180 plus 32, so that is equal to 212 Fahrenheit. For the given 100 Celsius temperature, what is the equivalent Fahrenheit temperature? That is 212 is the equivalent Fahrenheit temperature. So, this formula is used for converting given Celsius temperature into equivalent Fahrenheit temperature. Okay. Now, we can write the program for converting Celsius temperature into equivalent Fahrenheit temperature. First, we have to write header files, hash include stdio.h, standard input output header file. Second header file is hash include conio.h, console input output header file. Next, void main. Every C program execution starts with the main function. So main function does not return anything, so that we have to write void before the main function. Here I am taking only Celsius temperature by C, Fahrenheit temperature by F. We are simply representing these letters int C comma F. Semicolon. Next one, CLR SER. This is clear screen function. It clears the output screen. This function is available in the header file called hash include conio.h, so that we have to include this header file to our program. Next, printf, enter the Celsius temperature value. This value can be read from the keyboard by using scanf function. So scanf percentage D, double quotes, and ampersand C. So we are giving Celsius temperature value from the keyboard. For reading this Celsius temperature from the keyboard, we have to use scanf function. So here both printf and scanf functions are available in the header file called hash include stdio.h, so that we have to include this header file to our program. Next one, printf, the equivalent Fahrenheit temperature value is. This is only printing purpose, this statement. Now, what is the formula we are using? This formula. So F is equal to C into 9 by 5 plus 32. Okay. Next, after that, we have to write printf percentage D, double quotes, and comma F. So F is nothing but equivalent Fahrenheit temperature. After that, get CH, main close. So this is the simple program for converting given Celsius temperature into equivalent Fahrenheit temperature. Now output. Output is, enter the Celsius temperature value. So I am giving 100. Enter the Celsius temperature value. This statement as it is printed. Now we are giving 100 Celsius temperature from the keyboard by using scanf function. After that, this statement as it is printed, the equivalent Fahrenheit temperature is 100 is substituted here. So 100 into 9 by 5 plus 32. Okay. Then we are getting 212 is the Fahrenheit temperature. For the given Celsius temperature 100, the equivalent Fahrenheit temperature is 212. So this is the simple program for converting given Celsius temperature into equivalent Fahrenheit temperature. So this is the logic, this is the output, and this is the program. Now, here in this program, we have to find out the given Fahrenheit temperature into equivalent Celsius temperature. First, we are representing given Fahrenheit temperature by capital F. For simplicity purpose, I am representing Fahrenheit temperature by capital F and Celsius temperature by capital C. We have to find out the equivalent Celsius temperature for the given Fahrenheit temperature. The formula is C is equal to F minus 32 into 5 by 9. So this is the formula we have to use for finding out equivalent Celsius temperature for the given Fahrenheit temperature. Okay, so now suppose I am giving F is equal to 212 Fahrenheit temperature. Now we have to find out the equivalent Celsius temperature. Okay, so C is equal to, so F value is 212 minus 32 into 5 by 9. So 212 minus 32, that is 180. So 180 into 5 by 9. So that is equal to 920. 20 into 5 is 100. So that is equivalent Celsius temperature is 100. For the given Fahrenheit temperature 212, the equivalent Celsius temperature is 100. So by using this formula, we have to find out the equivalent Celsius temperature for the given Fahrenheit temperature. Okay, now we have to write the program. The program is, first we have to write header files hash include stdio.h standard input output header file, second header file hash include conio.h console input output header file. Next one, main function. Every C program starts execution with the main function. Main function does not return anything, so that we have to write empty data type void before the main function. Here, what are the variables we are using? So only C and F. So Celsius temperature is represented by C, Fahrenheit temperature is represented by F. Okay, so CLR SER, it clears the output screen. This function is available in the header file called hash include conio.h, so that we have to include this header file to our program. Next one, so printf statement. Printf, enter the Fahrenheit temperature value. Fahrenheit temperature value. So this value is read from the keyboard by using scanf function. So scanf, here the format string we are using is %d, because C and F are declared as integer variables. So then the format string %c. So ampersand F. So F is the Fahrenheit temperature that are to be read from the keyboard by using scanf function. Now we have to print the statement. The equivalent Celsius temperature is temperature value is, so slash n double quotes and parenthesis close semicolon. Now we have to write the formula. So C is equal to F minus 32 into 5/9. Okay, this is the formula we are using. After that, we have to print the Celsius temperature value. Whatever the result we are getting, then we are printing the Celsius temperature value. After that, get CH. Then main close. After that, main close. So this is the simple program for converting given Fahrenheit temperature into equivalent Celsius temperature. Now, what is the output we are getting? First, this statement is printed. So enter the Fahrenheit temperature value. So this value is read from the keyboard by using scanner function. That is 212 we are given. Then after giving, so this statement as it is printed, the equivalent Celsius temperature value is So what is the equivalent? After substituting 212 in this formula, then we are getting equivalent Celsius temperature is 100 in this way. So this is the program and this is the output and this is the logic. So thank you. Now we have to see the implementation of temperature conversion from Celsius to Fahrenheit and Fahrenheit to Celsius. Now this is the program for converting Fahrenheit temperature to Celsius temperature. The logic is already explained in the given program. Now we have to run the program. First, we have to save that program. Next, we have to compile the program by using the command called Alt plus F9. We are getting zero errors and zero warnings. Now, we have to run the program. For that one, we have to use the command called Control plus F9. Enter the temperature in Fahrenheit. Now, I am entering the temperature 212. The equivalent temperature in Celsius is 100. We are declaring the variables Fahrenheit and Celsius as float so that after the decimal point, so 6 zeros are getting. Okay. Suppose we are declaring the Fahrenheit and Celsius variables as integer, then we are getting 100. So enter the temperature in Fahrenheit is 212, that is read from the keyboard, then we are getting the output as equivalent temperature in Celsius is 100. Now again, once again we are running the program. Enter the temperature in Fahrenheit. Now I am entering 300. The equivalent temperature in Celsius is 148.888885. Okay. Now we have to see another program. Celsius to Fahrenheit. So this is the program. The logic is already explained in the previous session. Now we have to run the program. First compile the program. For that one we are using the command Alt plus F9. We are getting zero errors and zero warnings. Now
we have to run the program. For that one, we are using the command called control plus F9. Enter the temperature in Celsius. I am giving 100 from the keyboard. Then we are getting equivalent temperature in Fahrenheit is 212. Okay. Now, once again, I am running the program. Enter the temperature in Celsius. I am giving 300. The equivalent foreign temperature in Fahrenheit is 572. Okay. So, this is the output of the given program. So, this is the program. The program is already explained. Now, we have to see the implementation. Okay. Now, we can go for this program also. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel Divvela Srinivasarao. If you like this video, please click on the like button and waiting for future updates in my YouTube channel, and share this video and to your friends and classmates. Thank you one and all. Thank you for watching this video.